There are times when a specialty tool just makes sense, when a generic option just doesn't cut it. Now, I don't know if this video can even do these tools justice, but a year ago when I first started using these tailored pull stud wrenches, I knew that we had a winner. Hopefully, you can see just how precise and form-fitting these tools are. Each of these wrenches uses the pull stud itself as a guide, keeping everything secure under pressure. No twisting, no slipping. There is not much surface area on our pull studs for a regular wrench to grip, and using a larger wrench can make the problem worse, putting our tool centerline even further above the thin lands on our pull stud head. If you have installed pull studs, you recognize this uncomfortable wobble, even when using an open-end wrench. They can work, but are always right at the edge of slipping. Pull stud sockets work better, but even they twist and don't come close to the secure fit of a true pull stud wrench. The length of a Haas CT pull stud is different than that of a Haas BT pull stud. The BT pull stud is a little bit longer and is going to need a different wrench. Now, all new Haas mills are labeled, letting us know which type of tooling our machine needs. When it comes to pull studs, our holders can come in three different styles. BT, which is our metric standard, CT, which is our inch standard, and SK, which looks and behaves like a CT holder from the outside, but makes use of a metric pull stud. CT holders are interchangeable with SK holders. If your machine can take a CT, it can also take an SK DIN 69871 tool holder. SK holders have a V-notch on the flange, originally designed to work with certain tool changers. Now, Haas machines don't make use of this notch, but they don't hurt anything either. Now, BT holders are unique, exclusive. We cannot run a CT or SK holder in a machine built with a BT spindle and tool change arm. You can tell this is a BT holder right away by the flanges. They are uneven, with one flange much wider than the other, especially compared to a CT-SK holder. Different pull studs, different pull stud wrenches. Now, on a side note, this same style of wrench is available for ER collets as well. These ER wrenches wrap completely around the collet nut for the most secure fit possible. Now, form-fitting wrenches are available for ER20 and ER16 hex nuts as well. They are perfect. When I was a kid, I thought quicksand would be a much bigger problem than it is. Well, pull stud torque isn't the issue I thought it would be when it was a hot topic 25 years ago either. I have hit my knuckles too many times to admit while using poor fitting wrenches. But I have not really had a problem with pull studs loosening up when reasonably tightened. We recommend 65 foot-pounds, 88 newton meters of torque on our 40 taper pull studs. Our modern pull stud designs have a thread relief, which helps avoid the bulging of our holder if our pull stud is over-tightened some. A reasonably hand-tight 40 taper pull stud is going to have something like 6,000 pounds, 2,700 kilograms, of axial clamping force on it, which is more than enough preload to keep that pull stud from loosening up. If you are torquing your pull studs now with a torque wrench and a drawer full of adapters, I am not saying to stop. But if, like most shops, you are using a wrench of some kind to tighten those pull studs, it is time for an upgrade. A tailored pull stud wrench will make your current processes even more consistent. Do this, not this.